Besha, you're on the air.
Yes, I want to make a request.
What's that?
I want to make a request.
A request?
Yes.
Okay.
I want to hear Stake Him in the Heart.
What's that?
Stake Him in the Heart.
Stake? Stake Him in the Heart?
Yes.
I have no idea what that is.
It's the new single from Count Rockula and the Pennsylvania Blood Drinkers. The hottest and scariest band in Newbridge.
But what was the band called? Count Rockula?
And the Pennsylvania Blood Drinkers.
I'm going to go out on a limb here. And I'm going to guess that you're in Count Rockula and the Pennsylvania Blood Drinkers.
Wait, how did you know?
Just a hunch, I guess you could say. Because you're kind of calling. Asking me to play a song by something I've never heard of. And can I also guess, you're Count Rockula, aren't you?
That would be me. Listen, I'm a bit groggy from being asleep all day.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. What would really wake me up is to hear Stake Him in the Heart.
Okay.
You know, it was Song of the Week on horrormusic.com.
On what?
Horrormusic.com.
Horrormusic.com.
You've never heard of it? It's huge.
I've never heard of horror music. So what is it? A site that kind of puts the best music about horror?
The scariest monster rock.
The scariest monster. So, and you guys were what? Song of the Week?
Yes.
Is it super competitive?
It certainly is, yes. A lot of competition out there.
For Song of the Week on horrormusic.com.
Yes, and my song was Song of the Week.
So your song is a pretty weird title, Stake Him in the Heart.
Yes, it's about sticking a stake in the heart of an evil vampire. He has to be killed because he's such a bastard.
Okay, but I'm a little lost here because you're the vampire. So it's a song about killing you?
No, not me. I'm the good vampire.
You're the good vampire.
Yes.
I don't get
little
any
backstory, okay?
Okay.
Well, I come home by sundown, and there's a strange car in the driveway of my crypt.
Uh-huh.
I sneak into the kitchen, and I can hear passionate sounds of lovemaking from my bedroom.
Okay.
Someone was in bed with my wife.
With your wife?
Yes. So I pull back the covers. It was the evil Baron von Dracula.
Yeah?
He was diddling my wife.
Okay.
So I had to drive a stake through his heart.
So you had to, and did you drive a stake through his heart?
No, he ran off, and I couldn't catch him.
What happened to the voice?
That's all. Oh yes, I command you to play my single, Tom, or I'll stake you too.
Please, come on. Just so, play it, please.
You sound please. A little. You sound sad. Are you doing all right?
Come on, just play it, please. I sent it to you last week.
Well, Count Rockula, I don't know what to tell you.
Don't call me that. Just call me Todd, okay? I'm not really a vampire.
Oh, you're not really a vampire.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm glad you clarified that. I kind of had figured that out.
How?
Well, you said you were from Pennsylvania.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's where all the vampires are from in those movies.
What do you... No, not Pennsylvania.
Yeah, it is.
It's Transylvania.
What? No, yeah. Don't you remember in that film All the Right Moves when... Tom Cruise sucks the blood out of Craig T. Nelson's neck? That was in Pennsylvania. In coal country.
That was not in All the Right Moves.
I think it was, right?
No, it definitely wasn't. And what was all that backstory you were kind of saying about... What was he in... Count Baron von Dracula?
Yeah.
Was in bed with your wife and you came home?
Yeah.
To your crypt? You called it your crypt.
My crypt, yeah.
Yeah. Which is at what, actually?
That's my house.
Your house, yeah. Okay.
That actually did happen. I came home from, I came home from work one day, and mm-hmm. Baron von Dracula was in bed with my wife, Sheila.
So wait, there actually is a Baron von Dracula in this?
Yeah, he's the singer in that band, the Ghoul Patrol 66.
Ghoul Patrol 66. I know I've seen that name. Yeah. I know I've seen show posters, like flyers around Newbridge.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah. This guy thinks he's the coolest and the scariest rocker out there.
Mm-hmm.
And, that's why I formed Count von Dracula and the Pennsylvania Blood Drinkers, because I wanted to beat him at his own game. Mm-hmm. After he stole my wife and my son, Meller.
He stole what?
He stole my wife and my son, Meller.
Meller?
Yeah.
Your son's name is Meller?
Yeah, M-E-L-L-O-R.
What is that?
Oh, you don't know?
No.
Oh, that's Joe Strummer's real last name, Meller?
Meller.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, his middle name's Eno.
Your son's middle name is Eno. So you named him, okay. So it was Meller Eno.
Exactly, yeah. Mm-hmm. But this jerk, the Count,
yeah,
he's raising my son to be a vampire.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he's sending him to Newbridge Vampire Day School.
Vampire Day School.
Yeah. Guess who has to pay for it?
Guess who's, I'm going to guess you're paying for him to go to Vampire Day School?
That's right.
So he's got a vampire band.
Exactly, and I have a vampire band too.
And that doesn't, do you really think that in a town as small as Newbridge, we really need two vampire bands?
I'll be honest, probably not. And, you know, I've already lost my cape. So that's a part of it, why I don't think it's going that well. And my fangs keep falling out when I sing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, could something please go right?
So you lost your cape.
Yep.
And it's hard singing with the fangs in.
Yeah, they pop out.
But you're doing this, why?
Well, I want to get my family back. You know, mm-hmm. I want to show him who's boss.
Mm-hmm.
Look, but I'm pretty desperate, okay? I've been trying to get something going for the last 10 years, and just nothing's sticking. I'm just tired of stalking other people's music and not having any luck with my own material.
Stalking other people's music?
Yeah.
What was your name again?
Todd.
Todd.
Yeah.
Wait, this isn't Todd from Seedy Submarine, is it?
Yeah. Hey, that Bear versus Shark CD you ordered came in.
I ordered that, like, that had to have been, like, 10 years ago.
Yeah. Sometimes cargo is very slow fulfilling orders.
Like 10 years slow?
Yeah.
Yeah, that had to have been, like, 2003.
I think it was, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I'm actually not working at the Seedy Submarine anymore.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, you've been there, like, forever. How long? Like, 20 years, at least?
I think so. 18, 19, yeah.
Uh-huh. Definitely. So why are you not there anymore?
Oh, we don't need to get into that.
Come on. Tell me why you're not there after that amount of time working there.
You know, the usual differences.
Like, what are the usual differences?
Okay, well, I was helping this very pretty customer look for a CD, and she was pushing a toddler in a carriage, and I asked her if Daddy was still in the picture.
Ooh.
And I was also touching Dr. Winkle when I said it, and she went ape as hit, and I'm the manager, the guy in charge, so she couldn't really report to me to anyone.
Like she could, like she was like, I want to speak to the manager?
And it's like, I'm the manager, and how often does that happen? It's actually the manager of the store who's the one who's... does something unseemly. So what happened was that she reported me to the manager of the pod locker next door.
Of the what?
Pod locker?
What is pod locker?
You never heard of pod locker?
No.
Oh, well, it's a foot locker, but it caters to podcasters.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How, I don't know what that would be.
Well, one shoe has a $100 mic attached into it.
Okay.
And the other shoe has a GarageBand app.
So it records podcasts?
Yep.
From the shoes?
Yeah. I've never tried it.
Wow. I did not know about that.
Yep. Yeah. Anyway, so she reports me to Milt, the manager. He's 50, so of course he has authority over me.
Okay.
So he's got me in a headlock until my regional manager, Steve, comes and takes away my captain's hat and my keys to the front hatch of the store.
Okay.
But it's all going to be cool in the long run because it'll give me time to work on my box set.
What's that?
My box set. I'm putting out a box set.
A box set?
Yeah.
Of the vampire stuff.
All kinds of stuff, uh-huh. Yeah.
I mean, a box set's pretty ambitious. Why wouldn't you like start with like a single CD? Which, like, well, is where most people start.
Well, I already did that once.
Uh-huh.
And it didn't go well.
It didn't go well.
Yeah.
How did it not go well?
Well, it was back in 2000, mm-hmm. and I wrote and recorded 50 songs.
Wow.
Yeah, I even got a couple guys from the gas station dogs to play on it.
Okay. Wow, that's impressive.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it was this great concept album about how we're killing the environment and how we can stop it. And I laid out how we can stop it, and I spent a fortune on this record, and I hired a big-time publicist to promote it, you know, and this album, it had literally every style of music on it.
So really ambitious.
Yeah, jazz, blues, hardcore punk, metal, disco, techno.
Wow.
All on the same song.
So like one song?
Yeah.
With all of those styles?
Every song had all those styles.
Oh, okay. So it's a lot. It's a pretty long songs then.
No, the songs are pretty short.
Okay.
Yeah.
But each one was a different style?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes it was just like 3 seconds of disco.
Uh-huh.
And then 5 seconds of hardcore punk.
Wow.
But about 6 months after it came out, Shovel.com did this big story about how my record sold so few copies that the distributor, rather than sending the returns back to me, they just crushed them all and they piled them all in a big dump in the marshes outside of Newark.
Mm-hmm.
And it turns out that they dumped the 50,000 CDs on a raccoon colony. And they figured out that my CD about saving the environment actually killed about 245 baby raccoons.
Oh my God.
Yep.
So that's kind of what you meant by it not going well.
It didn't go well at all.
Yeah. That's
but you know, things are getting back on track, and I'm going to go full throttle, box set or bust, and I just know it's going to work this time.
Really?
Yeah, it's going to work just like it did back in junior high school, the time I won the candy sale.
When you won the candy sale.
Yeah, I really put my mind to it.
Uh-huh.
I sold 5 times what the other student sold,
uh-huh.
and I won the prize.
Okay.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, you know what the prize was?
What was the prize?
A lifetime supply of wacky packages.
A lifetime supply of wacky packages?
Yep.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Like how many?
A skid would arrive every week.
A skid
yeah.
of wacky, like, and how many... Because a skid is a giant thing of boxes.
Yes, it's like a pallet.
Okay, it was on a pallet of wacky packages.
Yep.
How many boxes were on the skid?
Well, 300?
So 300. How many boxes of wacky packages were in each box on the skid?
Probably 100.
100.
Yep.
So every week you got thousands of boxes of wacky packages sent to you.
I sure did.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
How'd that go for you?
Well, you know, I thought it went great. I mean, you know, sure, some of the kids said my dad sold most of the candy to the workers at his factory for me.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, those kids were all haters.
Mm-hmm. Well, did your dad sell the candy to everybody at the factory?
Yes. Why?
Well, then you're... you're writing them off as being haters, but they're accurate. They've kind of got you dead to rights on that.
Not really, no. I mean, I did it by any means necessary.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so you're doing this... So this is what the motivating thing is that you triumphed...
Yeah.
Back then by selling the most candy.
Yeah.
And that's what you're using as like the thing to kind of inspire you?
Yeah. Well,
now.
You know, you're making it sound tawdry and almost criminal.
But you're saying like this is the thing that helped you rise to the...
Yeah.
And that's what's making you want to do this box set?
Yeah. Well, listen, it wasn't all like roses for me after I won this thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, those wacky packages were fun at first, but they started to get to me.
They started to... Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like 7 months after they started showing up in those giant crates...
Yeah?
I lost my mind.
What? How so?
Well, I was having nightmares about drowning in bottles of top slob and being force-fed boxes of Minute Life.
So the wacky packages really got to you, like they kind of permeated your brain.
They sure did.
Oh, don't cry.
I can't help it.
I know, it's sad. I'm starting to get teary over
I
here,
know.
Too.
Oh, man. Those memories will just come back to you, you know?
Yeah. I mean, were there any other things that were in the dreams like that? Look, if it's too painful, I don't want you to go there, Todd.
They were smearing me with baby run. Look, I don't want to talk about this anymore, okay?
It's okay, man.
I want to play you a song I've been working on, okay?
Okay.
It's not cool.
It's all right.
All right, you ready to have your mind blown?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. Get my pipes in order. I was walking down the street just the other day when a hot-legged chippy started walking my way. I couldn't think straight. I didn't feel right, and then my dungarees started getting real tight. Long-legged sex pot, get into my bed. We can get crazy and then get out of our heads. I got a pile of pills I stole from my uncle's stash. We can get blasted and make love till we crash. Because, baby, baby, you're such a tease, but I'm a man who needs to be pleased. So please me, bitch, I need your love just like I need the love from God up above. Pills and thrills are the name of the game. I love the way I don't remember your name. It might be Kim. It might be Ruth, it might be Alice, and the only way to know the truth is when I go through your purse, when you're using the can, and if there's money in there, I'm gonna take it and scram, because, baby, baby, you're such a tease, but I'm a man who needs to be pleased. So please me, bitch, I need your love, just like I need the love from God up above. Ow! What do you think?
Wow.
Pretty cool, right?
Uh-huh. Well, I mean, that was not your... The music was... And the words were yours, I'm guessing.
Yeah, I wrote the words.
Uh-huh. But that's like Start Me Up.
No, it isn't. Well, technically it is, I guess. But that, you know, that's pubic domain.
What's that?
It's pubic domain. You don't know about pubic domain?
No, I know public domain.
What's that?
That's what you're trying to say.
Yeah, it means nobody owns it.
Yeah, public domain.
Yeah, like Camptown Razors.
What's that?
Camptown Razors?
No, I know.
Camptown Razors, do your thing, doo-da, doo-da. Camptown Razors, do your thing all the doo-da day.
It's Camptown Races, but...
No, it's Camptown Razors. It's about the Camptown Roller Derby team.
I don't know what...
Isn't it?
No, I mean, that's the team that always went up against the Lady Bombers?
The Bombers, yeah.
Yeah. That's not what that is, though. Maybe they did that, but that's not what the song started as.
We could debate that all night, I guess.
We probably could.
Maybe.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, Todd.
They slathered Ditch Boy paint all over me, too, in those dreams.
What was that?
Ditch Boy paint.
Ditch Boy. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Those cards really got to you.
They did, and they would spray Fright Guard into my face.
Uh-huh.
And they'd make me brush my teeth with Ultra Blight.
Well, you really need to maybe talk to somebody about these dreams.
They made me smoke Ditch Master cigars.
A lot of ditch stuff.
You know what kind of butter that I had to eat in that dream?
What?
Land of Quakes.
Land of Quakes. And that's like an earthquake?
Yeah, and I had this boombox.
Mm-hmm.
Like a portaghetto, from Radio Hut.
Mm-hmm.
But it was like being in hell. It would play for 2 seconds, and then it would just stop.
Mm-hmm.
You know why?
Why?
You know what kind of batteries were in it?
Can I guess?
Yeah.
Never ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. It happens.
Yeah. But this song?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's not so good, you know, but it's something to fill out the box set.
What is it with you and this box set?
I have to have a box set, Tom.
I don't know why you're starting. I mean, you did the one CD that turfed out and had some animal tragedy associated with it.
Maybe my publicist pulled a choke job on that. Did you ever think of that?
On that CD?
Or my manager dropped the ball. Did you ever think of that?
Well,
I didn't actually have a manager.
Okay. Yeah. So maybe it didn't happen then.
No.
But you did the one CD.
Yeah.
It didn't work.
No.
I guess that's a polite way of putting it.
Yeah.
But now you just keep going on. You're so focused on a box set.
Right.
What is that about?
Well, you know, any artist who's worth anything has had a box set. And I need one, and I need one to show my son.
Anybody who's worth anything has a box set.
Yeah.
And you want to show your son?
Yes.
The value of that you have a box that'll make him
exactly
respect you. How old is your kid?
2.
So, you're trying to please a 2-year-old.
Yeah.
Like, how's he... He doesn't know what box sets are.
Oh, I think he'll be very impressed when he's holding my box set.
Mm-hmm.
You don't?
I don't. I'm saying, I think you might be... It might be a little misplaced. Putting so much of a... Making it so much of a priority to impress a 2-year-old.
You don't think I should do this, do you?
Do the box set?
Yeah, just do any of it. It sounds like you're very judgmental.
You're laying out a pretty preposterous thing here.
You sound just like my family at the big family reunion that we had last week.
How so?
Well, I told everybody what I was doing about the box set and everything, and how I was going to get my vengeance.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, "What do you guys think about this?"
When you say vengeance, what do you mean?
Well, the Dracula band.
So the box set is a vengeance thing, also.
Oh yeah.
Uh-huh.
And guess what? Percentage of people in my family said it wasn't a good idea.
What was it?
Guess.
You want me to guess?
Yeah.
Exempting you.
Yes.
I'm gonna just lay it all on the table. Say 100%.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this is out of how many family members?
44.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you were like, "Hey, what do you think if we do this? What do you think if I do this box set to even the score with this guy in this other Dracula band, and also to impress my son?" And then they were just like, "No." Everybody said it was a bad move.
You know, maybe I'll just get my dad to sell them at his retirement home or something.
Are you okay?
What? Yeah. I'm just feeling a little weird. It's hard being hunched over for this long.
Hunched over?
Yeah.
Why are you hunched over?
Oh, Milt still has me in that headlock.
What are you talking about?
Milt.
From the store?
Yeah.
You've been in a headlock this whole time?
Yeah, since 2 o'clock today.
Wait, so that happened tonight?
Yeah.
The way you were telling it didn't seem like it happened. I can't believe you've been in a headlock this whole time.
Yeah, it's weird. It hurts. And it's hard to, like, it's really hard to, like, stay awake.
Mm-hmm.
I'm feeling very dizzy, and it's actually kind of peaceful. Oh, weird. I'm in a tunnel.
A tunnel?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's like a tunnel of light. It feels very good. A lot of my relatives are here.
Like what relatives?
Meemaw? Peepaw? Who's that? Is that Gigi Allen? Hey, Gigi. What? Ooh, why did you fling that at me?
Todd? Wow. Oof. It was troubling.